So here we have a monitor and a CPU. This is the power button. These are the USB slots, and these are the headphone slots. This is the button that turns on your monitor. You also have various other buttons that can be used to adjust various settings, such as brightness, darkness, and more. Here is the VGA data cable that gets plugged in here behind the CPU. This is your computer keyboard. It's just like a typewriter, but it can do a lot more than just let you type. In addition to the input of numbers and letters, it also lets you give commands and instructions, but more on that later. This is the cord of your keyboard. You can connect this either behind the CPU or in front. Generally, it's advisable to connect it to the back since it's a permanent device. This is your mouse. What does it do? Well, it is essentially used to give instructions. You can control it by moving it across a mat or flat surface to move cursor and choose any program. The mouse has a left click, a right click, and a scroller in the center. If you flip the mouse, you will notice an optical light. This is what helps the mouse detect movement. This is the cord of your mouse. Just like your keyboard, you can connect it either in the front or the back. But again, it's a permanent device, so we will connect it at the back. So let's get started and connect all of these. To begin, turn your CPU around. Here is where you will find all the USB ports you need to connect your devices. This is the power connector slot. This is where the VGA data cable goes in. These are the PS2 slots. In case your keyboard and mouse comes with a PS2 plug point, you can connect it to the PS2 slots. But since these have a USB port, we will connect them to their respective USB slots. Take the keyboard USB cable and connect it in this USB slot. Similarly, take the mouse USB cable and connect it in this USB slot. Always ensure that you use the first two slots and ignore the ones below for now. Now, let's connect the VGA cable. As you can see, it's got a V-shaped head. So where do we connect this? Find the slot that is also V-shaped and plug it right in. Once plugged in, screw in these knobs to ensure it's completely fixed. And lastly, we will plug in the power cord. This is your power cord. It's got a U-shaped head and has three pins. Connect this head in this slot over here. Once done, plug in the other end to any plug point. Congratulations! You are now ready to use your computer.